I'm part of the first team that has been identified as politicians, especially ministers and deputy ministers and mayors and MECs in South Africa, to be part of our National School of Government, to be able to be taken through on what requires us as government leaders, especially in the executive, to consider as we take certain decisions. There are politics at play, of course, but there are also economic challenges that we need to understand. So one of the things that this class has done to us is to understand the political situation that we find ourselves in, which should be matched with the economic downturn that confronts us as a country, especially because of COVID and other related things. So the basics of us understanding how investments, how we should put policies and legislations that can attract more investments in our country was very fundamental to us, because for us to be able to grow the economy, there should be certain considerations that we make. Example being the stability of the country, example being being able to attract more investments, putting legislative and policy regulations that can make those who want to invest in the country and create more jobs, and putting them in a more comfortable and stable way. And this is one of the things that we went at length to understand, and I think it's one of the things for me that has been a takeaway, because it then says, even if we don't, as politicians, are specialists on some of the things, once we get refresher courses of this nature to understand the broader framework of macroeconomics, what are the choices we have to make, what is the strength of our country, and where within all these competing priorities we have to look at. Of course, I want to say to the principal and those who have organized this program that this was really long overdue, and to those who have also contributed in fundraising and donating to make us to be part of this program, we really are grateful, and this should be sustained going forward.